Hey there, David. So you are me and I am you, but you're 22 and I'm 25. So at this point, I mean, we're almost identical twins here. We pretty much look the same. I don't really change too much in physical appearances. We sound the same pretty much. You are pretty much me, almost. But at 22, I do change great deal of. I think what's really important to me is that I constantly keep changing, keep evolving, keep growing. And that's something I realize is really important in my life. I know to you right now, my views on gun control and Second Amendment is totally different to yours. We have totally different political opinions on different things. I think gun issue is probably the most prominent example, but there's a couple ones, a couple of other ones too. I don't remember what you think too much to make that distinction right now. But I know I remember gun control being one of the main things that I kind of did a like a almost a complete 180 on. But it's not a complete 180. I'm not a gun rights person. I think Second Amendment is really important. And you actually are starting to view it that way, but you actually used to believe when you're 18 that all handguns should be banned and made illegal. So, we've come a long I've come a long way from that kind of political view. On this issue, I'm actually more of a centrist, actually. Leaning towards the right, actually, leaning towards gun rights and not towards gun control. But, I don't want to go through all the nuances of that. I made a couple of videos about the issue of America and gun violence. Made about five videos, so it's talked about there mostly. But I do want to say is this. You shouldn't be surprised that your political position on this has changed, has become more nuanced, and it's become completely different in a way. Because you did used to think that, gun control was an important thing to prevent incidents like the Columbine massacre, and Virginia Tech shooting. Did it happen by now? Or is am I talking about the future to you? I think it did. But anyway, that's what you believe. That's what I used to believe. But important thing about your personality, about my personality, is you believe in things, but you don't believe in things so dogmatically that you can't change your mind on it. It's important that you don't do that. You hold your values strongly enough, but also loose enough so that they're malleable. That's really important to you. As you learn more about it, it's possible that evidence could come up that totally disproves your view. And that's okay. It's okay to change your position because you want to support what is the truth and not what you believe as the truth. That's a really important distinction that you and I hold dear at this point. At this point, you're 22 years old, you really hold that belief. You come out of the deconversion process alive. You made it. You made it to this point, which is amazing. The first 2 years of becoming an atheist, of you becoming an atheist, you really struggled. You were angry at God. You were angry at yourself. You hated yourself for turning out to be an atheist for the first 2 years. Then the 2 years after that, you were just totally apathetic and careless about any belief system or whatever. You're just like, I don't care. I don't, it's whatever they believe is whatever they believe. Whatever I believe is whatever I believe. You just kind of shut yourself from that. We come a long way from that. Now we see the beauty of our old beliefs, and why they're so valuable, and we come to accept our own positions, and we accept that they're malleable, that they're changeable. If somehow, for example, if tomorrow, I don't know, what is one disprovable thing? If tomorrow, Jesus came down from heaven and was just like, I am God, and I always was, and I always will be, and believe in me, and you'll go to heaven. My complete view of whatever will be changed, and I'm okay with that. Based on the evidence, I'm okay to change my opinion, but evidence is really important. You can't believe in something just because you want to believe in it to be true, just because it's comfortable to believe in, just because it's convenient. You don't want to, I can't, and you can't right now, because now you've turned vegan. You can't believe that killing animals for human consumption is ethically justifiable. Given the evidence that we have, given the knowledge that we have, could I possibly change that position? Unlikely, but sure. If it can be proven to me, you know, if evidence piles up that, you know, is ethically justifiable, position could change. I always leave this tiny little room in my beliefs that my position can change based on the evidence. That's really important. And that's how you're able to have this 180. That you think, you know, that you can come to view as I do. That Second Amendment is an extremely important rights issue. It's really important that the American populace be able to own and use guns, and that has a political importance, that is of the utmost political importance for the security of this nation, for the way for it to function as well as it could, as democratically as well as it could, you know. But I'm a centrist in the sense that I don't really oppose sensible regulations on gun ownership. Right now, and it's probably not even discussed in your time, you know, by your politicians that much. But right now, recently, maybe it's not even talked about anymore because it was defeated. But recently, there was this whole debacle on background checks, and how there should be a universal background check on gun sales and gun purchases and all that. You know, I'm of the opinion that Second Amendment is super, super, super important, but something like that I actually wouldn't be opposed to. I'm all for a federal enforcement of federal. It has to be federal. It can't be state by state basis, but a federal level of background checks and enforcement of that. Not opposed to it, which is what makes me a centrist. More than, you know, leaning extremely on one side or the other. Also, I think that's the case for most things, most beliefs to hold dear. It's really dangerous to have an extreme view of one topic. I think in some cases it could make sense. In some cases, you know, it's good to have that one belief, you know, to be on one side of an issue because it's so clear that side is correct based on the evidence. But again, the point is that based on the evidence is the point. Whatever you come to believe in, it can't be because that's how you want to believe it or that's what you want to be true. It has to be because it's based on what you conclude from all the evidence that you have gathered. And there's always this possibility that you haven't viewed all the evidence. There might be still so much more evidence left for you to view that will change your opinion. And that's okay. That's what science is. That's how living life should be. Because that makes us grow as people. You know, being able to accept opinions that are different from us, from values that are different from us, and going, okay, I'll take that in, study it, study the evidence for it, against it, and then come to conclusions based on that. So important. And it's this, you know, the religious thinking of, or the dogmatic thinking of, I believe this to be right no matter what the evidence says, is the most dangerous way of thinking that a human being could think. And that is my current position. So, yeah. Hope this was a long video on just one that basic concept. So that's my video for this topic. And yeah, hope to see you later. Cheers.